Researcher Ali Kordamash starts her workday on skis. That's how she gets around on the alpine terrain where she studies the Teton Range bighorn sheep herd. Using GPS devices and trail counters, she tracks the movements of both sheep and skiers.
We really want to get a better sense of how bighorn sheep survive in the Tetons, both summer and winter. We don't know very much about this bighorn sheep herd. It's really small and really hard to study because they're so remote and hard to observe.
While other wild sheep move down to more moderate terrain, this herd winters at some of the highest elevations in Wyoming. They stopped migrating about 60 years ago due to human development, fire suppression, and other factors.
From a conservation biology standpoint, they are on the brink, and there's three primary reasons for that. One of them is the small size. It's a very small herd of sheep, about 100 total. The other is that they winter at high elevation in extremely rigorous conditions where there's very little to eat. And then the third thing is they're isolated from other sheep herds, meaning there's not very much genetic interchange.
Of 28 sheep researchers have been following for 2 years, seven have died.
Four of those seven have died in avalanches, which is interesting because historically when the sheep used to migrate down into the valleys, they wouldn't have to deal with avalanches in the wintertime. Hi, you guys going backcountry skiing today or just cross country?
Researchers also track backcountry skiers to see how they interact with the sheep. Jackson Hole Mountain Resort, a gateway to the backcountry, is cooperating.
We operate in the midst of what's likely one of the most intact natural environments that is actually inhabited by humans. And we take our environmental responsibility very, very seriously. And our guides, in fact, have taken some of the GPS units and been tracked.
Resort guide Bill Anderson carries a GPS while showing clients the pristine backcountry surrounding the resort.
When you're out every day and you seldomly see these creatures, it's really unique and interesting to come across them.
Some areas are off limits to skiers to protect these bighorns. The study offers an opportunity to see how effective those closures are, and a chance to discover how these wild sheep, residing here since the last ice age, still survive despite their diminished range. For This American Land, I'm Gary Stryker.